6 of John chapter 11. John 11, 6, and when he had heard thereof, therefore, that he was sick, Jesus now, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. Amen. I've heard my dad say one time that if Jesus was their pastor, he wouldn't have been their pastor much longer after that for staying in the same place 2 days after Lazarus had been sick. Amen. Oh, but you see, after Jesus received the news that Lazarus was sick, weak and feeble, Jesus stayed right where he was for 2 days. The natural man would think that Jesus was simply not concerned or that he didn't care. But Jesus here was not neglecting his friend Lazarus. He was waiting for a better time to demonstrate his love and power to them. Have you ever cried out unto the Lord before and it seemed like God was nowhere to be found? It's in those times, church, that we must trust that God is still in complete control. Can you say amen tonight? This is where faith comes in. Hebrews 11 and verse number 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Faith says, I may not see God at work right now, but I know that God is still good. Can you say amen? My flesh may feel as if God is ignoring me, but my faith says that God is just waiting for the perfect time to show up and to deliver me from my problem. Can you say amen? In the midst of your trial, don't you dare accuse God of being unconcerned or not caring at all. God is just waiting for the perfect time, the perfect moment to show up in your life and to bring you the victory. Your sickness is not unto death. It's for the glory of God. God knows how to turn it around, but before he does so, he's got to let it get worse. Can you say amen? Amen. There is an appointed time for your deliverance. You just got to stay faithful until it comes. Can you say amen? Now let's read John 7 through 11. We're just going to read this right here. 7 through 11. Then after that, saith he to his disciples, let us go into Judea again. His disciples say unto him, Master, the Jews of late have sought to stone thee. And goest thou thither again? In other words, you want to go back over there, Lord? They just tried to kill you and us. Amen. Verse number 9, and Jesus answered, are there not 12 hours in a day? And if any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he sees the light of the world. Verse 10, but if a man walk in the night, he stumbleth, because there is no light in him. These things he said, and after that he saith unto them, our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may awake him out of sleep. Now Jesus here is not talking about the damnable heresy called soul sleep. No. Jesus is just using that term sleep, amen, as if Lazarus had died. When Jesus said our friend Lazarus sleeps, Jesus was not saying that Lazarus was taking a nap, but Jesus was stating that Lazarus had died. Nobody had to tell Jesus that Lazarus had died, but God the Holy Ghost told Jesus when Lazarus had died. That is a comforting thing to know, because it lets us know that whenever troubles come our way, whenever calamity comes our way, Jesus already knows about it. He knew about it before it happened. Can you say amen? That's why Psalm 147 verse number 5 said, great is our Lord and of great power. Hallelujah. His understanding is infinite. Amen. God knows the exact moment. He knew the exact moment when Lazarus had died. And God knows the exact moments when you heard, when I heard. said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, see, the disciples are thinking, oh, he's sleeping, he's taking a nap. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. That'll be great for him. Howbeit Jesus spake of his death. But they thought that he had spoken of taking a rest and sleep. Verse 14, then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. Amen. When the disciples heard that Lazarus was asleep, they thought, great, that's going to be good for him. Amen. Get some rest and sleep, and maybe he'll just come out of it. Amen. But Jesus was not referring to that kind of sleep. Jesus said plainly unto him, Lazarus is dead. Verse number 15 now. And I am glad, Jesus said, and I am glad for your sakes that I was not there, to the intent that ye may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. Let us go unto that one named Lazarus that has died. Amen. Jesus was saying, I'm going, or I am glad that I was not there, because if I had been there, no glory would have ever come. He had never died in my presence, but I'm glad that I wasn't there, that he could die, because I've got to have him die that my glory can be seen. Because when you see what I do in the life of Lazarus, you're going to believe beyond a shadow. Say amen. Sometimes, church, God lets our situations die and completely deteriorate, because that's the only way we will believe God and give him the glory that's properly due him. Can you say amen? Moses had to die whenever he saw a Red Sea, and he had to have that Red Sea come to him before the glory of God could be seen. God's glory was never disciples. He didn't say it to Jesus. He said it to the other disciples. Let us also go that we may die with him. Amen. Now people have said, I don't know if Thomas was talking about, let us go that we may just stay where Lazarus was and die wherever he died. Or I'm kind of the persuasion where they were thinking Jesus is going to get killed if he goes through this town again. But if he's going to go, nevertheless, let us go that we may die with him. I think there's a reason why they call Thomas Doubting Thomas. Amen. Amen. It may have been said with a little bit of sarcasm. I don't know. But that's just up for your interpretation there. But that's the William Glasgow version of the situation. Amen. But let's read verse number 17 through 19. Then when Jesus came, he found that he had lain in the grave 4 days already. Now Bethany was nigh unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlongs off. And many of the Jews came to Mary, or to Martha and Mary, to comfort them concerning their brother. Think about that. All their friends are there to comfort, but Jesus was late. When Jesus and the disciples arrived, Lazarus had been dead for 4 days already. You know, it's the same thing now that It's on the fourth day after a person dies that that physical body begins to decay. There was no doubt that that's what happened to Lazarus. He was starting to decay. There was no doubt about it. Everyone knew that Lazarus was dead. See, scoffers say, well, Lazarus was just in a coma. No, no, no. There's a reason why everyone came to comfort Mary and Martha. There's a reason why Jesus told the disciples, Lazarus is dead. Amen. There's no doubt about it that Lazarus had died. Verse number 20. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still at the house. Think about that. When Jesus showed up, Martha ran to where Jesus was. She ran to Jesus with all of her questions, with all of her brokenness, her heartache, her despair. Sitting at the feet of Jesus while Martha was getting upset in the kitchen. So something happened to Martha. She realized to get a little bit closer to God. But listen, Mary sat still at her house. While Martha clung to the Lord in her time of heartache, Mary stayed home. The same Mary who used to sit at Jesus' feet while her sister was in the kitchen, the same Mary was now sitting alone in her house, mad at God. How many people do you know like that, church? They had something terrible happen in their life, but instead of running to God, they just sat at home, mad at God, mad at the world, spiritually dying. One of the saddest things for a pastor to see is to see someone who used to love and work for God, but because it seemed like God didn't show up on that person's time, the individual just stays at home, spiritually dying. It's of the utmost importance, church, that whenever we go through a heavy trial, that we don't isolate ourselves. You know what happens whenever an individual begins to isolate themselves? They sit in self-pity, they sit in worry, they sit in despair. Josiah, sit down. They sit in all their agony and all their pain when God says the whole time, I have called the church to bear your burdens. You don't have to carry them alone. But if we want to get like Mary was in this tent, we'll just stay at home. We'll isolate ourselves. It will get worse and worse and worse. And we'll die that way. Oh, but listen, verse number 21. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if you'd have been here, my brother hadn't have died. As soon as Martha reached Jesus, the first thing she did was she began to blame God. Yes, it was great that she ran to him. She was still better off than Mary was, just staying at home. But she ran to God. But whenever she got to the Lord, she said, if you would have been here, my brother wouldn't have died. God, you were late. God, you weren't on time. You're the reason why my brother died. She began to charge God foolishly. But in the next verse, Martha begins to come to her senses. Aren't you thankful for those times when God is just merciful? Hallelujah. Let's just lift up our hands. Aren't you thankful for the times when God is merciful? I believe that there have been times when maybe some of us even here tonight, I know I've done it before, I foolishly charged God. Oh, but he was merciful. Amen. And then there came a time whenever I started coming to my senses. Amen. Number 22, John 11, 22. But I know, she said, Martha said, but I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it to thee. Martha said, Jesus, whatever you ask the Father, God will give it to you. Jesus, I know you've healed the sick. Jesus, I know you've raised the dead. Jesus, I know that you're the Messiah sent from God. If you will ask, you will receive. Jesus, you told us in the scripture that if we ask, it will be given. If we seek, we'll find. If we'll knock, it'll be open. You see, Martha knew all the right things, but she just didn't believe it. There's a lot of people that know the scriptures, but they don't believe it. We can have all the head knowledge in the world about the Word of God, but if we refuse to believe it, it'll do us no good. Amen. We've got to mix the Word of God with faith. Can you say amen? Amen? Martha wasn't expecting Jesus to raise her brother up, but she was demonstrating that she knew God was able to do so. Let's hurry up. 23 through 24. Jesus saith unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Amen. Thank the Lord for that. Your brother's going to live again. He's going to rise again. And Martha said, Lord, I know that he's going to rise up again in the resurrection at the last day. I know he's going to rise. There's going to come a day when the grave's going to burst open and he's going to be caught up together in the clouds with you to meet you in the air. I know that. He'll rise when the rapture happens. Oh, Jesus said, he said, your brother's going to rise again, but Martha didn't understand what Jesus meant. Martha said, I know that Lazarus will rise again, but it will happen when the resurrection happens, whenever the rapture happens. She believed that Lazarus would one day rise, but she had no clue it would happen so soon. Amen. Verses 25 through 26. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Do you believe this? Believest thou this? Jesus said. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. The resurrection or the rapture. Really, I've been preaching a lot about the rapture lately. I could say I've been preaching a lot about the resurrection lately. Rapture and resurrection is the same thing, just names you can interchange. I like to use the word rapture just because that's more what we're used to nowadays. But the resurrection or the rapture of the church is more than it's more than just church doctrine. The rapture or the resurrection is in fact who Christ is. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Amen. And Jesus said, those who believe on me will never die. Jesus was not saying that our bodies would never die, but he was speaking of our souls. Amen. Whenever an individual takes their last breath, their soul and spirit immediately go to be in heaven. Amen. If they're a Christian now, that's why Paul said in 2 Corinthians 5 and 8, we are confident, I say, and willing, rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. After death, the body is still here in the ground, but the soul and the spirit are no longer here, for they have gone up into that eternal city called heaven to be with the Lord. But whenever the resurrection takes place, Paul told us in 1 Corinthians 15, 51 through 52, we shall not all sleep, but we shall shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. shall change our vile body, that it may be fashioned like unto his glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. Why will we be given these new bodies? Because Jesus said, whosoever believeth in me shall never die. Hallelujah. What a day that's going to be when my Jesus, I shall see. There's going to be a rapture. There's going to be a resurrection. And the Lord says to us tonight, I am the resurrection. It may be dead, but it shall live. Can you say amen? Oh, yes. Hallelujah. What a day that will be when my Jesus I will see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, and he'll take me by the hand, lead me through. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, church. Martha said, Lord, I know Lazarus is going to rise one day. He'll do it at resurrection in the last days, but that ain't good for me now. I'm hurting. Oh, but little did she know, Jesus wasn't just speaking about the time when Lazarus will, that physical body will raise up out of the grave. But he was talking about right here, right now. Your brother may be dead. You may think I'm 4 days late. His body is decaying. Hold on. Something is about to happen. Amen. We're going to learn that next week. Amen. Praise the Lord. You love Jesus tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. I'll tell you, I like us all tonight. Let's just find a place to pray. I'm going to have Sister Miranda just go around and pray with you tonight. Amen. But let's just say, Lord God, I'm looking for the day when you come. But oh, God, I pray, Lord, that my faith would not fail until then. Praise the Lord. Oh, Jesus, I love you. I praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, Lazarus died. But Lord, you allowed it because your glory was going to be seen. God, there may be times when we don't understand everything that's going on. But Lord, you did. You've got a plan, Lord. You've got a reason, Lord. You've got a purpose, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 2017 was a year that was filled with awful, awful hurricanes, awful earthquakes, awful tsunamis. I'm just talking not only here, just all over the world. And they're saying what it is it's global warming, it's this, it's that, it's this and that. I'll tell you what it is. It's the coming of the Lord. Amen, Sister Diane. The Lord is coming. Hallelujah. Now's not the time to fall asleep spiritually. It's high time. It's past time. Time to wake up. Yes. Amen. And realize, oh, the coming of the Lord, it draweth nigh. Amen. Jesus said, whenever I come, will I find faith on earth. Amen. I pray that when he comes, amen, he's going to see me filled with faith. Amen. Watching for him. Amen. You looking for the Lord to come? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Amen. If the Lord came right now, Kayla would have her thumb in her mouth. Amen. Not now. Amen. You ready for Jesus to come, Kayla? Yeah. Amen. Amen. So happy everyone was here tonight. I'm just so glad that Sister Diane is feeling better again. Amen. We give the Lord thanks for that. Continue this week, though, church, to just pray for one another. Amen. Let's bear one another's burdens. Amen. What's that mean? That's just me. Let's say, oh, God, I'm going to carry that burden. I'm going to act like it was me that was sick. I don't mean you walk around making yourself cough. It just means I'm going to pray as if it were me that was sick. Amen. So let's just bear one another's burdens and hold each other up in prayer. Amen. Let us pray before Caden gets up here. Heavenly Father, we just love you. We praise you. We thank you tonight for your word. I thank you for those who are gathered here tonight, God, and those that watch through social media. Lord God, I just ask you, Lord God, that as we dismiss in prayer, God, that if there is anyone here that heard this word tonight that is just frustrated, God, they feel like you were late. I pray that they would realize, God, it's not that you were late. You're just waiting for a better time to reveal your glory. They may say there is no better time. It's past time, but God, you see the end from the beginning. God, you said that all things work together for good to them that love you, to those that are the called according to your purpose. I ask you, Lord, to give your people traveling mercies. And God, just bring us back on Sunday morning ready to worship and praise you. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
right?
Huh?
Look out, baby.
You gotta go, baby.